Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Thursday, June 30th. Another terrific summer-like day in the Garden State, although the heat will start to build. Chief Meteorologist Dan Zarrow says the humidity is going to hold off for at least one more day. Temperatures should be in the 80s today. And then we're starting to look ahead to the long holiday weekend. We can tell you it will not be rain-free, but it won't be raining all the time. Dan starts previewing the holiday weekend weather on air, online at nj1015.com, and on our free mobile app. State lawmakers approved a record $50.6 billion state budget. It was generally drama-free, though there were still some theatrics inside the legislative chamber. Senator Declan O'Scanlan says with a $9 billion tax windfall, breaks such as tax-free back-to-school shopping and fee-free marriage licenses are pathetic and won't save most families any real money. Governor Murphy will sign the budget today, an event in Cranford. Republicans had been pushing for direct rebate checks to most residents of $1,500. Democrats wouldn't even consider those bills and blocked them from a vote. We have a full analysis of the budget, what's in it and what's not, from our Mike Simons. You can access that at nj1015.com or off of our mobile app. What is not in this budget is any relief from near-record-high gas prices, although prices did drop another penny a gallon overnight. Here are the latest numbers from AAA this morning. $4.87 a gallon for regular is the statewide average. AAA data shows Somerset County has finally dropped below $5 a gallon. A year ago, we were paying $3.13 heading into the 4th of July weekend. Prices have been dropping but are expected to rise again as more drivers hit the road for summer vacation. It took them weeks to admit, but state consumer affairs officials now say there is no state law that prevents Costco from restricting discount gasoline sales to members only. I've been following this story for weeks now. The change is expected to take effect officially next week. In 2004, consumer affairs officials told Costco requiring membership for gas was illegal, but nobody could find the law they cited. Now, in a statement, a spokesman would say only, restricting sales to members does not violate any of New Jersey's consumer protection laws. New Jersey is logging a couple more cases of monkeypox, total of 4 cases now in New Jersey, but doctors are continuing to stress that this is not any reason for alarm, and catching monkeypox is extremely rare. It is most often transmitted in skin-to-skin contact with an infected person. Union negotiators and casino management will be back at it again, trying to resolve contracts with the casino industry in Atlantic City and avoid a strike that could happen as early as Friday. Local 54 of the Unite Here union set the Friday deadline to reach a new agreement with Borgata, Caesars, Harrah's, and Tropicana. If not, they've authorized a strike. A fifth casino, the Hard Rock, faces a similar deadline early Sunday. The union is due to resume negotiations with Borgata today. Still no word how close or far apart the sides are in these ongoing negotiations. Lawmakers have approved a permanent extension of extended working hours for teenagers during summer months. 16 and 17-year-olds can now work up to 50 hours a week. 14 and 15-year-olds can work up to 40. Now, eventually, teens seeking working papers will be able to register online, but that won't be ready until next year. The change comes as employers continue to struggle to find enough workers. Democratic lawmakers did approve several new gun measures being sent to Governor Murphy, who says he will sign them. It is much of the package of bills that Murphy's been seeking now for more than a year. Regulation of the sale of ammunition, required training to receive a firearms purchaser ID card, allowing the state to sue gun makers for public health damages, and more, all approved by the legislature. Meanwhile, 9 guns so far this year have been found in carry-on luggage at Newark Airport. We are on pace to surpass the number of guns that were found last year, and TSA officials are alarmed. They're urging people to knock it off. It's a serious concern, says TSA New Jersey Director Tom Carter. The guns and other weapons were laid out before him at a news conference this week. Most times, he says, people tell police, I just forgot. Doesn't matter the excuse. You are still getting arrested in New Jersey if you're caught with a weapon in your carry-on. Some, but not all, New Jersey drivers will be able to renew their driver's licenses for free. avoiding the $24 renewal fee. That takes place from October of this year to September of next year. That was included in the state budget that was just passed. You cannot renew your license early under this bill in order to save yourself those $24. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's first news for this Thursday, June 30th. Have a great day.